So today we're pruning these petite pearl vines. These are three-year-old vines, and they're going to be trained as a high cordon training system. What we are going to do today is decide on the final cordons. And so what I want you to show you is what we did last year. You can see here there are multiple cordons in this vine. There's one, two, three, four cordons. And the reason why we leave so many cordons, and we always encourage this to our growers in the Midwest, is because of cold damage. If we have one of these cordons that suffers a lot of cold damage and it dies, it's very easy to replace this one by laying a cane that is coming from your alternative trunk. So leaving at least two trunks is ideal for growing grapes in cold climates. The other thing that I want to show you, and it looks very messy, but last year we decided to put two cordons per side. So this vine has four cordons. You can see here, one, two, three, and four. And so what I want to do today is I want to pick only two, because those are going to be the final cordons that we're going to leave for the lifespan of this vine. And what I'm going to show you is how I make a decision about what's the best cordon and how to start pruning it. So the ideal way of starting pruning it is to start pruning and spurring these canes that grew last year from the latter, the distal part of the cordon all the way towards the center. And the reason why we want to do that is because if you start pruning and spurring these canes that are up here first, if you have any dead material down here, you're not going to have any material to lay down as a new cordon. But if you start pruning from here and you start spurring these canes, and you come up to this middle part of the cordon and you realize, well, you know, I'm missing a lot of spurs, or there's a lot of like dead zone here, you can still use some of these canes that are on this side to just lay down as a replacement. So that's why we always start for this task on the distal part. It's much easier. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to start pruning, and I'm going to show you the two cordons that I left and how I'm going to pick one of them. So in these spurs, I'm actually leaving two butts per spur. And so there's one on this side, you probably can see with the camera, and the other one here. These are going to provide the two shoots for the following year that are going to carry the clusters. So there's going to be four clusters here of fruit, and the same here. These vines, hybrid vines, have basal buds that are for fruitful. That means that those very compressed buds that are just in the union between the cane and the spur here are going to break, and they're going to carry fruit. So many times growers would actually leave only one bud here plus the basal bud. In this case, just because we are training them for the first time, we just want to see what's going to happen, and we're going to leave those two visible buds here. But you can just prune them only to one. So in this case, we could prune off this one. There's this bud there, and I know that there's going to be a basal one that is going to break, and it's going to have also fruit. All right, so we've cleaned up all of the canes, and now we have all our spurs with two buds per spur. And now we have to make a decision whether we want to keep this cordon or this other cordon. And so if you look at the cordons, they both of them look really good and healthy. The only difference is that this cordon on this side is missing a spur position right here. Something happened here with the bud. It didn't break, and so we didn't get a shoot last year, so we're missing a position there. But if we were to count all the growth centers that are going to produce new shoots with fruit, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. We have 13 spurs. If each one of these spurs produce two shoots, we're going to have 26 shoots, and then we're going to have about, you know, maybe around, we could potentially carry like 50 clusters on this side. So that's a lot of fruit. But what we want to make sure is that these are going to be our centers of growth for a very long time. So we want to make sure that these spurs are in good position. This one that you can see is going down is great for high cordon because the shoots are going to come down. In this case, this is going up. So we're going to have to, you know, let those shoots flop down during the growing season. These positions underneath are ideal because then we don't have to do anything with the shoots. But this cordon is great, has a lot of centers of growth. This one as well, if we count here, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So this one has 12 and the other one has 13. The only good thing about this one on this side is that it has no dead space, while this one is missing one right here. So this area here is not gonna be productive. The other thing before we decide which one we're going to leave is to look at where's the origin of these different cordons. So this one here is one of the trunks that is coming up from here, while this one, this other one, is coming from this other trunk on the other side that has 1, 2, 3. And so since we're probably going to choose one of the other two canes to produce this cordon on this side, I'm going to be more inclined to keep this one because it's an independent cordon. And so I'm going to remove this here, and I'm just going to keep this cordon as my final cordon for this particular vine. So I'm going to detach it from the wire. Take it down, and then I'm gonna bring my loppers. I'm just gonna make a clean cut right here. I can get the loppers in and remove it. And now we have here our final cordon for this vine.